Hi, welcome to Five Facts with Danny. That's me, I'm Danny. I'm out here in the Milwaukee Arboretum, which is a prairie ecosystem at our Riverside Park branch of the Urban Ecology Center. And it's the last days of summer, which means that this is a really critical time in the life cycle of grasshoppers. They've laid their eggs, and now they're probably enjoying one of their last meals before they're going to die. The most common species of grasshopper that you can see here in Wisconsin and in all of America is the Carolina grasshopper. And so, in honor of these final days of the grasshoppers, I'd like to share with you today five facts about the Carolina grasshopper. Here we go. Fact number one, the Carolina grasshopper is not a butterfly. This is an understandable mistake to make because the most often times that we see Carolina grasshoppers is when they're flying. And when they're flying, they look an awful lot like a butterfly. So they do have black wings when they open up their wings and jump off to fly. However, they're not butterflies, they're grasshoppers. So the most often time you'll see a Carolina grasshopper is when you're in a prairie or field, open field ecosystem like this, and you're walking along a path. That path is usually nice and warm on the sunny days of July and August, and the grasshoppers will flush up and you'll see it jump up and you'll see those black wings as it flies away from you. That is not a butterfly, that's the Carolina grasshopper. Fact number two, the Carolina grasshopper has a lot of different identities. So all of your entomologist friends are probably going to refer to the Carolina grasshopper by its scientific name, Dysostyra carolina. However, there are a lot of different common names for this particular species. So of course, Carolina grasshopper, the black-winged grasshopper, Carolina locust, the Quaker, the road duster are all very common names that this species of grasshopper is referred to. Honestly, this is probably just a quirk of it being such a common species. When something is in such great abundance, a lot of different names are going to evolve that people are gonna use for it in different regions and in different ways. Fact number three, the Carolina grasshopper would make an excellent dinner date. They will eat pretty much anything that's available to them. So in pretty much any habitat that the Carolina grasshopper has been found in, scientists have examined the contents of its stomach and it has been eating whatever the predominant vegetation is of that habitat. So they're able to really easily adapt to the plant composition of the habitat that they're in. Fact number four, because they're able to adapt to so many different habitats, once they establish themselves in a habitat, it's really easy for their population to just grow in rapid numbers. So remember, one of the names for the Carolina grasshopper is the Carolina locust. And this is an example of when we hear the expression swarms of locusts, this is what we're talking about. So if the habitat is good and there's lots of food readily available to them, there's no reason why their population isn't just gonna take off into these huge numbers. And throughout history, there have been lots of documented effects of these large, large groups of Carolina grasshoppers just absolutely wreaking havoc on a habitat they're in, whether that is a prairie like this one I'm in, or more commonly and more recently, fields of potatoes, sorghum, tobacco, alfalfa, those common crops. Again, the grasshoppers are able to adapt to it. So they'll eat and eat and eat, and their population will just grow and grow and grow until they've completely taken over and overrun that ecosystem. And fact number five. So like I mentioned at the top, we are at this very critical point in the life cycle of the Carolina grasshopper. Most of them have laid their eggs by now. They'll lay their eggs in the ground, and those eggs will spend all of winter and most of the spring too underground developing and waiting until the weather gets warm enough for them to emerge. In early to mid-June, that's when they will emerge. And at that point, they're in a point of their life cycle where they're called a nymph. So a nymph is not the adult form yet. And what's gonna happen is that nymph is gonna change usually between 3 to 5 times. It's going to shed its exoskeleton and molt over and over and over. Each of those different stages is called an instar stage until it reaches the adult grasshopper form. So we probably won't see an adult Carolina grasshopper until next July. And then July, August, beginning of September, that very short period of time is when they're in that adult form. They'll lay their eggs and then next fall, those adults will die, and the cycle will continue year after year after year. And so there we have our five facts about the Carolina grasshopper. If you do happen to be lucky enough to see an adult Carolina grasshopper in the next week or two here, be sure to wish it a fond farewell. Thank it for gracing us with its brief, brief presence here on Earth, and wish it well as it moves on to the great grasshopper beyond. But don't be sad, because next year the cycle will continue and we'll have lots of Carolina grasshoppers all over again. So until next time, thanks for watching. Have a good one. Bye.